Hello, it's Patrick here from the GarageBandGuide.com. In this video, I'm taking a closer look at GarageBand's Bitcrusher plugin. Included as a plugin effect from pretty much GarageBand's first iteration, the Bitcrusher is a fantastic tool for adding a lo-fi edge to your projects. Whether you want to completely destroy a synth melody or add a little crunchy colour to a drum pattern, GarageBand's Bitcrusher is a surprisingly versatile tool. Here's how it works. You can find the Bitcrusher plugin right at the top of the distortion submenu. Like a lot of GarageBand's built-in plugins, you're getting a stripped-down version of GarageBand's big brother Logic Pro 10's effects. In this case, the GarageBand version of the Bitcrusher allows you to tweak the resolution and downsampling effects. The resolution sets the bitrate between 1 and 24 bits. This alters the calculation precision of the process. Lowering the value increases the number of sampling errors, generating more distortion and nasty sounding stuff. The downsampling slider reduces the sample rate. A value of 1 leaves the signal unchanged, a value of 2 halves the sample rate, and a value of 10 reduces the sample rate to 1/10 of the original signal. For example, if you set downsampling to 10, a 44.1 kHz signal is sampled at just 4.41 kHz. You'll find some presets to play with here, which range from things like the 4-bit classic, which will wreck pretty much any sound you apply it to. To AM radio, which adds a little more subtle distortion. And more. So here's some ways that I find using the Bitcrusher useful. Double a drum track and add the Bitcrusher effect to the duplicated track. Lower the volume of the affected track and dial down the resolution. This will add a subtle crunch to your drum tracks when played together. You can also use automation to give a bit of creative flair to an intro or breakdown in your track. Open automation on the region or track you have the Bitcrusher active on and choose to automate downsampling from the submenu. Put your first automation point on or close to zero and place the second at the end of the section you want the effect to take place, near to the top. This will create a gradual degradation effect that sounds really unique and works very well in the right circumstances. there you have it. That's a deep dive into GarageBand's Bitcrusher plugin. Which of GarageBand's plugins do you want me to take a closer look at next? Leave a comment below and let me know. If you're not subscribed already, then now's a great time to do so and hit that notification bell to make sure you don't miss a thing. I've been Patrick from thegaragebandguide.com, and I'll see you next time. Bye for now.